You know, that is another nature of the lamb. The zip it. The scripture says it opened not its mouth. So you must learn to zip the mouth. Don't talk unnecessarily. Don't talk. There is much sin in the multitude of words. Very specifically, I was told that the youths must be trained, prepared as the Joel's army for the last days. You know, if you look at Malachi chapter 4, verse 5 and 6, I have read it hundreds of times and never understood it for years until 2 months ago. I always wondered what that scripture meant, you know. It says here, "Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and terrible day of the Lord. And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children, and the heart of the children to the fathers, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse." So I never understood the meaning of this scripture. What does it mean? Turning the heart of the fathers to the children, and the turning the children's hearts to the fathers. So many preachers have explained that this will be the turning of the children's heart to the Father God. I accepted it for some time until I read the scripture again. It says, fathers. If it is Father God, it should be Father in the singular. But here it says, fathers. That caused a problem. There's not many fathers up in heaven, you know. We only have one Father. Right? Do you believe that? Only one Father, no? So, which means the scripture does not talk about the believers and Father God in heaven. Doesn't. Something else. So, who to us? The various commentaries that I've read does not give any explanation for the scripture. But I was puzzled. Something there. You know, it's always my habit. If I don't understand something, I never preach on it. First, I must understand, you know, before I can say, turning the heart of the fathers to the children and the children to the fathers. I must explain what that is. If I can't, I should not preach. So, 2 months ago, when I met Elijah in Jerusalem, when he was giving me this teaching about Jezebel, he asked me at one particular time, "Do you have any questions to us?" I said, "As a matter of fact, yes, sir." He said, "You know, I don't understand this scripture. What does it mean? You are the one. It talks about you. What does it mean?" You know, he's like a father. He just smiled and he said, "That speaks about your generation. Fathers, you fathers must understand the children. You must understand the call that is upon the young people. And don't see them as a threat. Groom them, encourage them, and spur them to move in their callings, to move in their anointings, to do the works of God that they have been called to do." And the turning of the children's heart to the fathers, what does it mean? The children now must recognize the fathers in the faith. They must recognize them. Oh, these are our fathers. These are our elders in the faith. And allow themselves, submit themselves to be mentored. It's a twofold mentoring process. The older fathers, the generals in the Lord's army, they mentoring the youths that will rise up, and the youths looking up to them. You see, in the army, it's the soldiers who go to war. The generals don't go to war, you know. They sit in the war room. They make all the plans, right? The captains, the majors, they train the other soldiers. And the soldiers learn from those military generals, higher icons. They learn from each other. No one is a threat to one another. But at present, the leadership looks at the youngsters who are rising up as a threat. To
Don't allow him. Let's pull the rock under his feet. Right? Do you have that here?
Yes.
See, we are all in the same boat. No. You see the anointing upon the young people. Groom them. Encourage them. Lift them up. Okay, you do it. I will cheer you. That's my duty. That's our duty. The general's duty. To give the battle plans to the youngsters. Battle plans to the next generation. Okay, this is what you do. I've got this battle plan from the Lord. Now this is your part. Now take it. You read it. You go. There are so many different kinds of warriors in the Lord's army. You know, they are footmen. And they are horsemen. And they are charioteers. Those who ride on the chariots. And then there are those who fly on the clouds. And then there are those who fly on horses. Different kinds in the Lord's army. And all work together as one united body. Footmen, you know. Even the footmen, they are different kinds. There are some footmen who wield a sword. There's another kind of footman who wields a shield. Then there's another footman who throws the javelin. Now these are all not human weapons. And you must know how to hold the sword, because there are wings on the sword. You must know how to mount on the horse. You must know how to talk to the horse. Have you seen the movie Horse Whisperer? It doesn't work like that. This is a different kind of a horse whisperer. Of course, horse whispering. You must know the language of the horse. And you hold the reins in your hand. You must know what the left and the right means. You know, if you pull wrongly, you ended up wrongly. There was once a man, you know, a pastor, who trained his horse to say, Hallelujah, Amen. Hallelujah means the horse will run. Amen means the horse stops. So, one day he got on the horse, and for some reason, the horse lost control. It was running so fast, and all his amens were not working. Finally, the horse came to a cliff. Suddenly, he said, Amen! And the horse stopped. Hallelujah! So, you must know the proper language. Then the chariots. Every part of the chariot is a weapon. The wheel is a weapon. The chariot, when you stand, is a weapon. The horses is a weapon. You know, when the horse does like this, that's a weapon, you know. That's a weapon. And when you mount on the horse with the wings, the wings on the horse, it's a weapon. And you must learn how to command all those weapons. They are like something like missiles, you know. They come out of all these things. I saw all that. I was given all this teaching to train the next generation. For weeks and for months, taught all these things, one by one by one. And you mount on the clouds. The clouds is a vehicle of transportation. You get on the clouds. You must know how to steady yourself on the cloud. You see, all these things are the war manuals in heaven that God will give us to train the youths. So they should be prepared. Should be prepared for this last day's war.
Remember, the war is real. The threat is real. Nothing is spiritual. It's physical. And you must not love your lives unto death. That's the final qualification you need. You must not love your life. You must be like the lamb, sacrificial. You know, lambs are born to die for you. They end up as steak, right? You know, I was teaching recently about this lamb, the sheep, and my staff told me a very interesting incident that happened in his life. He grew two sheep, and for 3 years he was rearing them and growing them. It was like a baby to him, you know. And when they were about 3 years old, his grandmother told him, "Now you are not looking after the sheep anymore. I am very old, I cannot look after the sheep, so sell them away." So reluctantly he brought them to the butcher. One sheep is the older, the mother, and the other is like a lamb, smaller one. So both he brought them to the butcher. So then he stood there before the butcher and he bargained, haggled over the prices. So the man agreed and he took the mother, chopped its head and hang it up on the ceiling. Now all this while, the other little lamb was watching this entire scene, and it saw its own mother being chopped, all the blood drained, and hanged up on the hook. In a little while, this other lamb would end up like that. And do you know how that little lamb reacted? It just remained quiet. Never moved an inch. Though it was looking at the whole scene at the same time. It saw the blood on the floor. It saw the chopping knife. It saw the mother hanging on the hook. It saw everything, yet it never moved. Just was there still. Still, standing still. Like a lamb brought unto slaughter. That opened not its mouth. You need that character. You need that character. That sacrificial attitude. That character. That is a qualification. Important qualification. If you don't have that qualification, you are disqualified to receive the powers of the age to come.